If you think about it, 3D printers are pretty big hypocrites. You spend half the time trying to get your first layer to stick, and then when your 3D print's done, well, you gotta pick up this stupid spatula and then like hack at it and bust the prints off. It's really hard, and half the time you're gonna cut your finger in the process. And now it is 2018, and some printers are blessed with removable print platforms. So we have the amazing Prusa Mark III with a print platform that you just pop the parts off. And you can buy magnetic print platforms. For example, this is the flex plate from BuildTac that can stick to your print surface, but it's pretty expensive. And not everyone can afford such a luxurious item. So in today's video, we're going to try to make our own magnetic removable print platform with some L plates. Let's get started. Okay, so to do this project, you will need these. These are flexible magnetic plates for cars. These are loaners in Australia. You can get P plates as well, whatever. You can get adhesive backed ones with magnets, but they're a little bit more expensive and I couldn't be bothered waiting for them to turn up from eBay. To stick to these magnets, you're gonna need a thin steel sheet. Now, this is from a novelty sign shop. Very low cost, it's just standard steel. It's not as good as spring steel. It does have these rounded edges here to make sure you don't cut yourself. And don't worry too much about what it says or not, because we'll be covering it up with this. This is just a thin adhesive build surface. This is Wanhao Fake Tack. You can get real build tack if you like, doesn't matter. You just need something to stick over the top of the steel. And because I don't have adhesive backed magnets, we need some double-sided tape. So let's get started. Okay, so this is the JG Aurora A3 3D printer. I've removed any print surface on it. And before you stick anything down, you really wanna clean it. So I've got some metho and I'm just gonna wet the cloth and clean off any oils or residue or anything you might have on the print surface. Obviously this printer's off and nothing's plugged in because we are working with a solvent, which is quite flammable. And this is pretty clean already, so I'm not too worried about that. Okay, next we've got our magnets. And unfortunately these L plates don't stick to the L side. So I can't have them facing up like that. They have to be facing like this. Then the sheet will stick to the top of it like that. So these are a little bit too long. So what I'm gonna do is just figure out roughly where to put them. That's probably fine. And just get a marker and just mark very roughly. And we're gonna use our double-sided tape to just lay some strips down so we can stick our magnets down. Now these don't cover the whole bed, and this steel sheet is just a little bit smaller, but the advantage of that is the steel lip is quite thick and it'll actually just sit inside these magnets. So hopefully it should sit nice and flat. Okay, now we're just gonna stick down our flexible build surface. This is a one-shot job. And it will overhang our plate just a little bit, but that's okay. No one really prints right up to the edge of their build surface anyway. So there you have it, guys. We've made our DIY magnetic removable print surface. So a few things to note. This isn't spring steel, it's just standard steel. So the parts flex off like diagonally because of the strengthening ribs. And over time it might slowly start bowing. It's not gonna be as resilient as spring steel. Also, these magnets and the sheet add a few millimeters of thickness, so you'll have to re-level and also maybe even move your micro switch location on the Z-axis, depending on how much room you have with your springs. And the final note is something called the Curie temperature with magnets. So the reason that the Prusa Mark III and the BuildTac flex plate have discrete magnets built into it, not a flexible magnet sheet, is they have a higher Curie temperature. Whereas these sheets are rated to apparently 180 degrees C. I don't know, I wouldn't really trust pushing it very, very high at all. In fact, I would recommend printing without any heat because you're printing PLA, you don't need heat on your build tack surface. And if you want to push it up, I'd say maybe 60 degrees or so. Keeping in mind, like these sheets are designed to be stuck on cars in the hot summer days. So they probably can cope with a fair amount of temperature of heat. But if you're gonna try to print ABS or something, it's gonna destroy them. And once it reaches past the Curie temperature, it's irreversible. They're no longer gonna be magnetic. So I'm gonna level this, start a print, and let's see how it works.
Now you can explore microscopic worlds.
Alrighty guys, how did we go? Well, actually, this seems to have worked way better than I expected. The print's complete. The magnets did not demagnetize, so it turns out we did not reach the Curie point. It was originally at 60 degrees Celsius, and it still had some stick, and then I reduced it to 45 degrees C. So printing PLA, 45 degrees C is fine. And I actually hit it with the FLIR thermal camera to see if there was any sort of cold spots on the edge, because we've only got the magnets up to here. And actually, you can see the footage here, which I'm going to overlay. It actually seemed to be working pretty good. We, you know, we had a temperature of about 40 degrees Celsius over the entire bed without any obvious cold spots. But the true test, does it flex the parts off? Well, yes. Perfectly, actually, and that just sticks back in place. Now, it is very thin steel, and over time, it may start to deform, but honestly, I am really, really happy with how that turned out for a project video that was actually going to be a bit of a joke. Anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed this video here on Maker's Muse, and if you want to see future 3D printing tips, tricks, projects, reviews, all that good stuff, then hit that subscribe button. I'd love to have you on board. And also want to take this opportunity to thank my Patreon supporters who keep this channel going, keep the lights on, and keep the power running for these very hungry little machines. Anyway, till next time, guys, look forward to seeing you again very shortly. Happy printing, guys. Bye.
In the latter half of the 20th century, a man has sent rockets into deep space. He has placed satellites into orbit.